three total goals in his first three games under Joe Sacco. So got a couple of wins, but the offense really hasn't been there. Zadorov shot is swallowed up by Sorokin.
It's got to be tough, guys. 10 years, assistant coach. Well, you've got a relationship with players. It's not as a head coach. It's assistant coach. There's subtleties to it. Uh-oh.
Right off the face off, the Bruins take the lead 57 seconds in. That one surprised Ilya Sorokin, and it's Brad Marchand who opens the scoring this evening.
Absolutely no chance, and Casey Cizikas lost the faceoff, but boy, that faceoff was won so clean. Watch what Marchand is. He's right at the top of the circle right there. Puck comes right back to him. I mean, it just doesn't get any better than that, and as quickly as...
And Butch, that's tough right there. You see a little pick on Isaiah George. It's difficult. You want to put your stick out there to get that puck instead of blocking it at the same time. That thing's coming right for your face, just a touch late, but it is a perfect draw and a nice shot by Marchand.
Zips it across to Mason Laura. Through to Zacha. Zacha in. Hands it off. Shot saved by Sorokin. Rebound up in the air as he shrugged it to the slot. Another one of the Bruins who split last year between Vancouver and Calgary. Jaloski long shot. That sails through and is gloved down by Korpisalo. That's the first time he's touched the puck. Hit a couple of sticks.
I can't talk on faceoffs, Alan. They're too dangerous today.
Nobody's winning any faceoffs.
To the net! Crashing back door, but unable to get it to go was Kastelic. Stayed in it first, and then Johnson taps it over the line.
Good shift there for the Islanders. A quick transition, and Horvat ends up getting a decent shot, and then they go to work. That's how they have to play.
The door off through. This one touched on for Brazzo. Trailing the play and scoring is Marchand, his second goal in the opening 7 minutes.
Marchand comes in and undetected because he came in behind everybody. Watch number 63. Everybody's looking at the puck, and he just tracks it a little bit late.
And Butch, for me, not really firm in the neutral zone. They had bodies in place, but no one picked anyone up, and it's that second wave when you got people in the right place. But Patrick Waugh is going to call timeout here, and
this might be their turn to come back.
Yeah, you do play a little bit differently sometimes, Butch.
Yeah, you do. You're a little more relaxed, and you know, now you know you have to go for it.
Although
Patrick Waugh hinted that Vashing would be in on the Washington game, which is coming up. We'll see if that comes to fruition.
The Islanders with a back-to-back this weekend. Turn over to the front, and they score! Max Simlikov gets the Islanders back to within one right at the doorstep.
He said, I'll just try five hole, and there's a turnover there by the Bruins, and Simlikov, a little chip shot. That's one the goaltender is going to walk back. He didn't get a whole lot on it, but was in the right spot. Watch the stick of the goaltender. A little bit of a hole there, but that's a much-needed break for the Islanders and as well for Simlikov as he knocks that one out of midair.
First goal since November the 3rd for Simlikov. As Matt Martin throws the body around, turnover again. Wallstrom's backhander, and Korpisalo got enough of it.
And Wally had more time there, and I think all he could think of was, I got to change, but he had plenty of time to do something better.
Dobson to the side, Pageau with the nifty little redirection.
And it gave them a lot of energy, Thomas.
Horvat off the draw to the net. That one stuck to Korpisalo as O'Meary brushes it out. Bouncing puck. Brought down nicely by Nelson. He backpedals. Simlikov opens up and a shot produced. A rebound. It's still available. Scramble in front. Where's it at? It's dug out of a crowd by Lindholm. Taken by Geeky. Jumped over a couple of sticks. Geeky on for Zacha. Trying to rip it back door. Kicked away by Sorokin's pad. Shot's dead even at 8 apiece. No penalties yet in this game as Carlo juggles it. And then to the net, Sorokin was able to melt that one down with 1:41 to play.
The difference between the bottom and the top to shrink each and every year, and so far, mission accomplished.
Extra diligence required here as you look at Joe Sacco, the new coach. Wait a minute.
Here's Nelson in to the net. He scores! What a shot for Brock Nelson, and he has tied the game on the rush.
That was a tough bounce at the blue line. Shot that I wish Brock Nelson would use more often, and I don't mean how hard. Was that, look at the tough bounce by the defenseman Laurie, and this, that's in the Toyota part. What, it's bouncing. Now Brock settles it down, and I mean, that is just right where it ought to be, and no chance for the goaltender. Huge goal. You know, Thomason, you watch Brock. Brock likes to shoot. I think they've been really good together.
Pasternak looking to the middle, trying to find Zacha. Need to deal with Palmieri. Take away. Here's Pez, or rather, Zacha to the back door. And the Bruins retake the lead. Far side of the ice, it's Morgan Geeky to make it 3-2.
And it all started with an errant pass as Romanov just tried to bounce it off the glass and hit the Bruin player. And then the Bruins went to work. And Bruins get up the ice. And nothing happening here. It's all good. Watch Romanov. He's got the puck. Just doesn't make sure. And then a quick pass. And Dobson's trying to do the right thing. It's just a good pass. He's caught in between Thomas.
And Butch, this is so tough for a goaltender, right? Honor a shot. You have to honor the shot. You have to honor the shot. You got to rely on someone to pick up that late guy. It was a beautiful, perfect pass.
Pollock to George. Here's Horvat. Got Pollock waiting for it out high. Nelson for Horvat. A dozen seconds left. Pollock. Nelson skates his stick. Shot scores! Second of the game for Brock Nelson. He tucks it home short side.
Go in on the forecheck, cause a turnover between Horvat and Pollock. Looking to try and get the puck. And talked about where Brock Nelson likes to shoot, Thomas. Low on the blocker side. Well, there it is, and able to make it.
And here's Horvat ahead. Islanders have numbers here if they push it. Horvat across. Pajot. Horvat shot kicked away.
That's just a great save there by the goaltender. Is he able to get himself out of the... That actually was on the right side of the point. Yeah, just a little bit. But he's got chances. Good playmaking there. 3-on-2. Give it right back to him. Corpusello does an excellent job to get back towards the net.
And now Marchand gets the wheels turning. And he'll dump it in.
Thomas, you're seeing both these teams now start to play the chip and chase game. Under 10 minutes, not Nick Martin to make any turnovers at the blue line.
One time shot, oh, that leaks through Sorokin on Andrew Peak's blast that was tipped in front. And the Bruins have retaken the lead with 9:12 to go.
We talked about this, the winning goal last game, and that's a tough puck for Sorokin. He can't get out to it, but can you tie up a stick? And we're going to watch John Beecher and find him here. Can you get underneath the stick?
Yeah, that'll be Pavel Zacha.
Zacha, I'm sorry.
Yeah, Zacha, and this time it's Chalosky not pushing and shoving and leaving the stick loose. And that's, for me, that's not the way you should play defense. And it's hard to move people out of the way, and he gets a stick out. And it was the same scenarios the other night, two goals where the Islanders were in position.
Knocked away from Siplikov on for Pasternak. He's got a couple of assists in this game. Zacha. Nikita Zadorov back towards Pasternak. Out front, it comes backhand shot. Zaka's got another one. That's two quick ones for Pavel Zacha. And the Bruins lead 5-3.
The Islanders' coverage isn't good. There's the little chip and chase, and the Islanders couldn't quite control it. Zacha gets it back to the defenseman, and there it goes down low. Win the battle one-on-one. So Pasternak, what, with three assists now, and Brock Nelson trying to cover Zacha, just couldn't quite get the angle on him. And then Sorokin just hasn't been able to get out of his net tonight. All four goals, he's been in his net.
Zadorov to his feet. Here's Nelson. Reaches back. Fired one, never got to Corpusalo. Zadorov out of the box. Puck shot wide. He'll get to it. And it's a slam dunk for Nikita Zadorov. Fresh out of the penalty box. And for the second straight game, the Islanders have allowed three in the third.
And that's good timing by the Bruins. Would you say you couldn't time that any better? But who continues to get a lot of opportunities and just can't seem to find the back of the net. You need a little luck here and there once in a while, especially when you're having trouble scoring. And his luck is nothing but bad. And Zadorov, number 91.
The Bruins jump above 500 with their 11th win. And it's a 6-3 final tonight on Long Island. Jonas Corpusalo gets the win.